6 months.
That's a quick one. Okay. Welcome to SportsCenter. We discussed this the other night. It's a big event when the Leafs go west.
Absolutely.
Because the Leafs, whether you love them or hate them, they're a very popular team in Canada.
And Southern Ontario has the biggest population base in the country, and Southern Ontarians move out west to take jobs, and they get one chance a year to see their Leafs in town, and they're going to buy all those tickets from the season ticket holders.
That's right. So the Leafs' western road swing continued in Vancouver.
That's right, Dan. Freddie Anderson's been on fire. He's actually tied for the league lead in wins with 32, tied with Marc-Andre Fleury. First period, Vancouver power play. Alex Edler's shot snagged by Freddie. He's coming off back-to-back 35-save victories. Then in the dying seconds of the first period, Edler. Anderson stops that one, too. Stopped all 15 shots he faced in the first period. No score through 20. Second period. Hey, look. It's the $12 million man, Mitch Marner. Leafs shorthanded. Marner, two-on-one with Ron Hainsey. Great patience by Marner to slide it under the stick and feed Hainsey for his first goal in 20 games. Marner's point streak is at 5 games now. Toronto opens the scoring 34 seconds after that. Patty Marleau strips Derek Gouliot. John Tavares finds Vancouver native Morgan Riley for his 17th of the season. What a year he's having. Probably lots of friends and family in the stands. Back to Anderson, dying seconds of the second period. Bo Horvat absolutely robbed by Freddie the Goat. What a save. 20 saves through two. You know, Toronto's the only team without a loss this season when leading after 40. Final frame, Adam Gaudette to Louis Erickson. And he beats Freddie for Vancouver's first goal in nearly 116 minutes of gameplay. Under 2 minutes later is Josh Levo, the former Leaf. Boomsies! Vancouver 9-1-0 in their last 10 at home against Toronto. They get up for these games. At the other end, Jacob Markstrom. His turn to flash the leather. This time on Tavares. Looked like that one may have been going wide. Markstrom coming off back-to-back 40-plus save performances. This one needed OT. Under 2 minutes left, Edler finally solves Freddie. Little wrist shot there, keeps it low. Toronto's first loss when leading after 40. Vancouver, a big 3-2 win in OT.
There's been a lot of talk about the Calgary Flames goaltending this season, as there is clearly no number one. Mike Smith and David Riddick have shared the net evenly, and both have, at times, played great, and both have, at times, played come see, come saw.
Both goals back in November.
Riddick starting consecutive games for the first time since February 12th. Pre-game finds a new way to photobomb by throwing his equipment in the background of Derek Ryan's interview. The Flames in Vegas. First period, Vegas man advantage. Mark Stone. Stopped by big save Dave Shea. Theodore on the rebound. Riddick has allowed 6 goals twice over his last 4 starts. 1-0 Golden Knights. Marc-Andre Fleury's posted back-to-back shutouts. No goals allowed in nearly 169 minutes, the longest stretch of his career. Still in the period. Rasmus Anderson. He stopped. Johnny Gaudreau on the rebound scores. Hang on, Vegas says. What about some goalie interference on Matthew Tkachuk? They win the challenge and no goal. Is that the guy from Ferris Bueller's Day Off?
That's right. Why it makes it so difficult. Alan Ruck.
Yeah. Interference. This is the right call, but so the shutout streak continues. Mid-second. Flames rush on the power play. Travis Hamonic steps into one. He had 1 goal last season. He's now got 7, upping his career high. And the shutout streak is over. Tied game in the second.
So, the West standings look just like this. And Vancouver, with those 2 points, I believe Vancouver is Vancouver at 65 points now, so they are very much in this wild card race, despite producer Tim's objections. And a crazy battle between four teams for those final two wild card spots, with Dallas and Minnesota currently holding down the wild card race.
Caps and Flyers, Alex Ovechkin, 3 points shy of 1,200 in his career. He went viral this week. Why? Well, his wife posted a video of him eating a bowl of borscht, that's cold soup, and wearing a running sucks shirt. Ovechkin then decided to share some of that home cooking with his teammates after a morning skate, although that soup looked to be heated early in the first. Incredible second effort from Ovi from his knees. Gets it to Tom Wilson with a wide open cage. Ovechkin already leading the Rocket Richard race with 45 goals on the year. Tom Wilson, 19 goals. Ovi, 31st assist of the season. Can Borscht be warmed up?
Yeah. You can eat it hot or cold.
Okay, Caps up 2-0 after one in the second. John Carlson keeps it in at the line. Nick Backstrom delivers the pass. Ovi does the rest. Beats Brian Elliott for his 46th. He's within a point of 1,200 in the third. Washington with another man advantage. Ovi, wide open cage. Oh, pulled off the line. He's robbed of a goal. Yeah, Cam Talbot entered the game. Ovechkin within inches of reaching the milestone as the Caps still take it. 5-3. They've got nothing going wrong in the playoff picture. The Flyers, they're way back. And according to Hound Dog Harrison, our stats guy, he said they're pretty well toast in their postseason efforts. That's the Flyers.
Now, 11th place in the Western Conference, trying to get his own coach fired. Several failed attempts to trade basically his entire team. If only we had a piece of video that could serve as a metaphor for LeBron's first season in L.A. Thank you, former Canucks anthem singer Mark Donnelly. But on Wednesday, LeBron had a chance to reach a truly significant personal milestone, and he was tweeting about it before the game,
the court, whether
anticipating
that's like, for example,
the moment
the chase down block that he had on
where he
Williams,
may pass the king.
Competing and switching
well, no, he's the king,
big and small,
and he's passing Michael Jeffrey Jordan in all-time scoring in the NBA. Well, not all-time scoring, fourth all-time. I'll get it right eventually. LeBron, for three, only seven away from passing MJ. So LeBron would move into fourth, and Jordan would go back to fifth. That's right. Only Karl Malone, Kobe Bryant, and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar will be ahead of LeBron after this night. LeBron inside, and then here, ties Jordan's career mark with that jumper. And that leads to this. And he only needs about 350 points to move past Kobe. Very emotional after that milestone. Obviously, wears number 23, so he idolizes Jordan. Lakers are still terrible. I mean, they are awful. Now, this is LeBron's 1,190th game. It took Jordan over 100 fewer games to score his 32,292 points. And there you see the list of players ahead of the king. One team is last in the NBA's Western Conference. One is last in the NBA's Eastern Conference. If only there was a piece of video that could serve as a metaphor for the season the Knicks and Suns are having. It pretty much works for anything. But the good news is those teams have the best chance at Duke super freshman Zion Williamson and Canadian R.J. Barrett. So you might call this the battle for Zion.
Excellent basketball.
These are the only two teams mathematically eliminated from the NBA's postseason already. Kelly Oubre Jr.
Pass inside to Oubre. This is the jam.
And then knocks it out of bounds. So that was all around horrible. The Knicks trying the alley-oop. DeAndre Jordan not even close with that pass. The Knicks had 21 turnovers. Oh, there's the fizz. Poor guy, good coach. terrible team. Clu Gray Jr., chance at redemption. Going coast to coast, and wedgie.
And he'll jump it up.
The Suns hand the Knicks a league-leading 52nd loss.
A couple of easy layups tonight, trying to dunk this.
So
one.
There you go. Producer Tim still continuing to research the history behind those Chicago Bulls jerseys. So. Looking forward to hearing that. Complete debrief at the end of the show. You got some shoe issues?
Yeah. Because it's so cold and it's so dry, the static. My pants were stuck up on my leg because of the staticness.
You need some bounce in your life.
Or Static Guard.
Yeah. It'd be cool if Static Guard sponsored our walkover clock. Rivalries are exactly what the NHL wanted when it went from the old 1-8 playoff system to the current format back in 2013. The league has no plans to change it, despite the argument that some of the NHL's best teams will be eliminated in the first and second round. Thanks to the current setup, that's how it's been going the last couple of years. The league is standing pat. They say when the top two teams meet early in the playoffs, fans get the best version of those teams, as opposed to later in the playoffs, when teams and players are run down, full of injuries, and gnat-filled beards.
But here's the problem with the NHL. They never admit that they got something wrong.
Right. Yeah, no, they're not big on that. Admitting mistakes.
Yeah.
Not a huge thing for them. Like currently Calgary and San Jose, the West's top two teams on a second-round collision course. Bruins and Leafs set to play in the first round. They're third and fourth in the overall standings, so.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, I could see both sides. I understand the trying to make division races more important.
And
I,
they say it cuts down on travel, too, in the
right,
future.
Right, right. But, yeah, overall, I'd love to see it change.
We showed you this on Tuesday's show. Brad Marchand, he tweeted that Mitch Marner should get $12 million annually on his next deal. Leafs GM Kyle Dubas. Oh, you talked about that on Wednesday.
I think it was a master troll job, to say the least. You have to respect that element of it. And for my end, I think the part that that I liked about it was that, you know, there's over a 90% chance we're going to play them in the playoffs if you just take the probabilities of it. And so that he woke up in the morning of a game day and was thinking about the Toronto Maple Leafs, I thought was a positive thing for us.
See, it's a fresh voice coming from the GM meetings.
Kyle Dubas is a... I really like him. Like, I just like the way he approaches this kind of thing, has fun with it. By the way, Brad Marchand, not only is he trolling the Leafs, but he's probably trolling his own agent, because he is making $6.125 million through 2025. He's 4 points back of Marner going into Thursday's action, or Wednesday's action. Now, as we showed you earlier, LeBron James passed Michael Jordan for fourth on the NBA's all-time scoring list in Wednesday's game against Denver. But despite having LeBron in the lineup this season, the Lakers have plummeted out of the Western Conference playoff race. LeBron is on track to miss just his third postseason and first since his sophomore year in the league. And nobody is currently projecting that the Lakers will make the playoffs. Nobody.
That's right. Everyone is set on the Lakers, and we mean everyone.
Come on down to Discount Sports Ball Warehouse Los Angeles Lakers Blowout Sale. We're stripping our mannequins and emptying ourselves of Lakers gear because they are not making the playoffs. Lakers plus LeBron equals perfect fit t-shirts, 50% off. Anthony Davis Lakers jerseys, two for the price of none. These guys should for sure be here hoodies, minus $15. LeBron, 9 finals in a row boats, must set sale. All things Rondo must Ron go. Palenka Drinka energy drinks, we're pouring them down the drain. We believe in magic coffee mugs, however many you want. Come in this weekend and we'll throw in this plaque of LeVar Ball frowning. We were told LeBron activated playoff mode. We thought Paul George would at least take a meeting. Discount Sports Ball Warehouse Lakers blowout sale. We're probably going to have the same sale next year.
They've made some
probably
bad decisions.
Now, when we come back, Dan, this is exciting. We've got the 5 Ds: dunk, dodge, dip, dive, and dunk. They're all in the chain.
Let's see what Bradley Beal does here.
Beal,
oh boy. He was on a runway to that hoop. No one in his way.
This next one could be the highlight of the night. Alex Ovechkin, as he's falling down. Great feed to Tom Wilson.
Spring ball.
Yeah, this is a big deal.
Nolan Arenado.
diving stop.
He's amazing.
Well, five-time Gold Glover.
Sixers and Bulls, Ryan Arcidiacono. Amazing play to keep the ball inbounds, get it up to Otto Porter Jr., who lobs it to Zach LaVine. Arcidiacono. Great hustle, great play.
How about Arcidiacono?
Jazz, Pelly's, Rudy Gobert.
Could have been an and one, a break for the Pelicans.
Okay, maybe this will be the highlight of the night. Freddie Anderson. The sick mitt. To Rob Bo Horvat.
Ooh, ref cam.
Love this angle.
Bo's doubled over in disbelief.
To get that shot off, just to
Spurs and Hawks.
White in the paint.
Wow.
Producer Tim is obsessed with the Jannies, and tonight he went all up.
How many were there? 48 Jannies we just did.
Tons of Jannies. Great, great segment.
Yeah.
I think producer Tim deserves a lot of praise for that one.
It is his favorite part of the show.
He really does love it.
Because it's highlights, and we aren't on camera.
That's right. He likes to keep us off the television. So get ready for... in years to come, the Jannies to expand to 16, 20 plays. And then eventually, the show will just be called Jannies.
Yes.
Fine. Tennis, Indian Wells, California. First round, Bianca Andreescu of Canada. Now ranked a career high 60th in the world, facing Irina Camelia Begu. Dropped the first set in the tiebreak, leading 5-3 in the second. And she forces a third. Being down a break and trailing 3-1, Andreescu battles back. The forehand winner. And then the 18-year-old serving for the match, Begu sails her forehand wide. And Andreescu, the Canadian, wins 5 straight games to secure a win in her Indian Wells debut. And there's an In-N-Out Burger practically across the street from that place, so she can go celebrate with a double-double animal style.
And there's a Nobu in that facility.
That's right, Dan.
Time for the Jay and Dan Newsroom. Boston Bruins. They'll be without Marcus Johansson for at least a week after he suffered a lung contusion Tuesday against the Hurricanes. Johansson was kept overnight at hospital for monitoring following a hit from Michael Furlan. Johansson, 1 assist in 4 games with the Bruins since they acquired him February 25th from the Devils. Lung contusion. It's an injury you don't hear very often.
The old lung bruise.
Yeah. Yeah, contusion is another word for a bruise.
It's like getting bruised ribs, like you had a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
Can't really do anything about it.
Mine are almost healed.
Want me to rub them for you?
Sure.
Let me rub your ribs.
It's feeling a lot better back there.
The Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim have contacted Major League Baseball to look into a possible tampering violation after Bryce Harper said he would definitely call Mike Trout to recruit him when he becomes a free agent in 2020. Harper, not willing to walk it back.
I mean, if I didn't mean it, I wouldn't have said it, you know, so.
What was it, the equivalent of being called into the principal's office, so to speak?
With what?
Them saying, hey, don't do this.
No, I mean, I've never been called in the principal's office, so I don't really know what that means. So I'm not sure what you're trying to ask, so.
Well, baseball said, hey, we're gonna look into this.
Yeah, I mean. They look into everything.
Yeah, Philly media, get used to that.
Yeah, Trout was born in Vineland, New Jersey. That is about a 40-minute drive to Citizens Bank Park in Philly.
And so. Harper should be okay, because they pointed out, he said 2020. He said, I'll call him in 2020, not like tomorrow.
But if you're the Angels.
I know, of course.
I get it. I get why they're...
Boston Red Sox pitcher Stephen Wright has been suspended 80 games after testing positive for PEDs. He's a knuckleballer. Made 4 starts and 16 relief appearances in the 2018 regular season. This is Wright's second suspension. Not sure why a knuckleballer would need PEDs.
Yeah, it's a very confusing story. He will be eligible to return in late June, but will not be eligible to play in the playoffs for Boston Everyone expects them to be there again. According to ESPN's Adam Schefter, multiple teams are interested in a deal that will likely have Antonio Brown traded out of Pittsburgh by Friday. Brown has 3 years and $36.43 million in base salary left with Pittsburgh. No guaranteed money remaining. The 30-year-old owns an NFL best six consecutive 100-catch seasons, but he was benched in the final game of the 2018 season because of a missed work day in Week 17. I'm so happy for this to end.
I've got the three teams who have reportedly shown the most interest. Raiders.
Gruden.
Titans.
Titans.
Washington.
Be interesting.
And this has been the Jay and Dan Newsreel.
Well, it's time now for another edition of our popular sports food segment. Sports food. That's right. BC Place unveiled a new menu item to kick off the 2019 season. One of the items that caught our eye was the Outrageous Burger, which contains three beef patties, 40 chicken fingers, six strips of smoky bacon, and one hot dog, all between two succulent brioche patties. Or buns. Now, not to be outdone, the Rogers Center announced a new extreme food for their menu.
This should be good.
Blue Jays' upcoming season. It's called the Mucho Outrageous Dog. It's a plain boiled hot dog, no bun, and it costs $16. Blue Jays GM Ross Atkins is said to be very excited about the potential of this hot dog.
And that's already vaulted to the top of the best food choice at Skydome.
Absolutely. I could see lots of people with a plastic fork and knife and a paper plate on their laps, carefully slicing segments of the hot dog off and slowly, meticulously chewing each bite as the Jays lose yet again.
Still to come.
SportsCenter with Jay and Dan will not be seen next week, so prepare to miss comedy like this.
How's that beet salad? Did you eat it?
Not yet.
The f***?
We're back March 17th.
Looking forward to it. We're taking a week off, everybody. Phillies, Jays, Aaron Sanchez making a second start of the string. And by the string, I mean spring. Gave up one hit, two walks over 2 2/3. Kevin Biggio hit his first home run of the spring, takes Vince Velasquez deep to right center. The son of Hall of Famer Craig Biggio.
It's windy there, too.
1 for 4 with a walk. And then Anthony Alford, another top prospect for the Jays, went deep for the first time. Little opposite field. Owie. The Jays beat the Phillies 9-7.
Well, speaking of producer Tim, he blew it. This is our segment. We pointed our errors. He did not look up the Bulls City Edition jerseys. Turns out Thomas, he looked it up, another one of our producers. They were inspired by the Chicago City flag.
See, that's a simple thing that you'd think a veteran producer like Tim would have found out or researched or had someone research on his behalf. But Tim let that detail slip and makes you wonder what other details Tim is letting slip over the course of this show.
I blew it. I said Nolan Arenado was a five-time Gold Glover. He's six-time. You blew it during the Jays highlights. You said string training, not spring.
And we have a tweet here, Dan.
Oh, okay.
We got to show this. From Brad Biggs. Said the Bears have signed kicker Chris Blewett. Former Pitt kicker Chris Blewett. So he can be playing for the Bears.
His parents missed out. First name should have been yeah.
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 No belt.
No, we don't
need one.
No, we don't need
one. Don't need one. Been losing a ton of weight. Look great.